about is nature versus nurture, which means the innate qualities a person was born with versus the traits that they gain from the way they were raised and who they grew up around. I believe, as do most scientists, that nurture has the greater influence. For example, it has been proven that children with divorced parents are at a greater risk of anxiety and depression. Single parents also tend to completely misunderstand their child because of the child's possible resentment about the divorce. In one study that was conducted, single parents reported that their child knew why they got divorced, that they would never live together again, and that their children felt angry at mostly their mothers, but the children reported that they did not feel that way at all. Environment also plays a huge role in someone's personality as well as their national character. For example, Americans have the stereotype of being fat and lazy, but as we all know, there are many Americans that are not fat or lazy. Most of the time, however, certain cultures agree with the stereotypes about themselves. Psychologists Robert McCrae and Antonio Terracciano have discovered through research that the French view of Germans is similar to the Germans' view of themselves and vice versa. The first source that I used, or the first stimulus source that I used, was the Looking Glass House. This shows the effects of nurture versus nature through Alice's imagination. It is shown in this chapter that Alice has been raised in a home where people don't seem to pay much attention to her. And because no one talks to her or plays with her, she pretends that her cats do, along with many other things. Alice wouldn't have such a huge imagination if she had people around her to play with. The second source that I used was attitudes toward Muslim women in the West. This source talks about how the interest in Muslim women spiked after 9/11. And I believe that so much light wouldn't have been shed on Muslim women and this interest wouldn't be so prevalent, if it was not for the culture that they were raised in and where they lived. To what extent does someone's home and environment affect the way that they are? And as I continued researching and looking into the second article that I used, the Muslim women one, I changed it to be like, how does it affect the way other people view them as well as the way that they have turned out?
The real world implications or consequences, i.e. influence on others' behavior or decision-making processes of your findings. What are the implications to your community?
Well, I think that if people were to take a step back and think about why someone acts the way that they do, like if somebody's mean to you and you're just like, oh, they're an awful person, that's just how they are, but maybe you should like take a step back and think, okay, well, why are they being mean? Well, look at where they were raised, look at how they were raised. Like, their parents were mean to them, so they're mean to other people. And I think it would lead to a less judgmental society, almost, if people could kind of understand